Say that the average person has about 60 to 70,000 thoughts a day. The challenge is 90, 95% of them are the same thoughts they had yesterday and the day before that. You can't affect real big change or transformation if you're doing the same thing, right? Because you know this, insanity, doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. So I wanna train you to activate your quick brain so you automatically wanna act and apply. And the way we do that is by taking simple steps, making little tiny steps. And so what I'm gonna ask you to do every single morning as part of your morning routine, as you're brushing your teeth, using that as a reminder and a trigger, to try brushing your teeth with the opposite hand. Now, here are a couple reasons. Number one, it trains you to be mindfully present. Now, what's the benefit of that? Most people are so distracted, but how do you maintain your focus and concentration in a world full of app notifications and social media alerts and all these different things that are vying for your attention? You train the muscle of focus and presence. So when you're brushing your teeth with the opposite hand, it forces you to be in the moment. And that power of presence, that presence of fitness, that attention muscle that you're building to make it really fit, that will show up when you need to be present, when you're remembering someone's name, when you're reading something and you get easily distracted. It trains those muscles to be present with what you're reading and also studying. So that's number one, it trains your presence and mindfulness. The second reason you want to use the opposite hand, there's research done at Duke University, the Department of Neuroscience and Biology, by Dr. Lawrence Katz. He wanted to find out how to keep seniors' minds alive as they aged. And what Dr. Lawrence Katz found was simple exercises like eating with the opposite hand or brushing your teeth with the opposite hand, where you're challenging yourself, that we know that there's a mind-body connection, but there's also a body-mind connection, that as the body moves, the brain grooves, actually stimulates different parts of the brain. So what we're doing here, as you're trying to brush your teeth with the opposite hand, it's gonna feel difficult, it's gonna feel a little bit weird. But the reason why is you're creating new neural pathways and you're clearing up the metaphorical traffic jam that's in people's minds when it comes to their memory. They're slow to remember things because that freeway is not clear. And so you're moving things around, you're challenging yourself in new ways, you're making new connections, because as your body moves, your brain grooves. So what I challenge you to do for those reasons, number one, trains your muscle of fitness. And number two, it trains a different part of your mind. And the third reason is you want to train yourself to do difficult things. Because here, I do believe the point of doing these challenges is with challenge comes change, that the treasure you seek is found in the work you're avoiding. And it trains you to take on little difficult things, because if you want an easy life, you don't do easy things, right? The easy thing is to procrastinate, to put things off. But the hard thing is to do the hard things, is to do the work that you need to do. Because if you just do the easy things, life is hard. But if you do the hard things in life, life becomes easier. So you're training yourself in the first thing in the morning to do something difficult, because you're training your muscles. So maybe it shows up in the areas where you need to make a call, a sales call, or you need to give a presentation, or maybe you need to fire somebody, giving them, have a difficult conversation with them. And so because you built that muscle of grit, so that's the third reason. If you want a different life, you need to change your habits, because first you create your habits and then your habits create you. And so if you get really good doing new things and creating new habits, what other things can you do? Maybe you could create a habit of mindfulness, a habit of saying, I love you, a habit of eating the right food, a habit of working out every single day. So at a meta level, you've developed the habit of creating empowering habits.
If you liked the video, a sub to the channel would be incredible, and also share the video to spread the word. You can watch another video, just click left or right. Keep inspiring.